Some of you, if you kind of pay attention to details, which I'm not one of them, but some of you are like that. You might know, you know what? Just a little while back, we commissioned Dan as a pastor here at Trinity Church. And it seems like ever since then, we haven't seen him on Sunday morning. And so exactly, some of you are like, what's up? So I think that's just my first question, Dan, is what's up?
In the Bible, Philip and the Ethiopian, and he, you know, baptized the Ethiopian, and all of a sudden, boom, he moved on. And I kind of felt like, you know, God's done a little bit of the same with me. They commissioned me as pastor, and then all of a sudden, I disappear. So sorry about that. I actually have been doing ministry work. I haven't been just sitting on the couch eating bonbons, you know, watching reruns of Matlock. So I'm sorry, in January.
That was really specific.
Yeah, wasn't yeah. Right? Maybe I have been doing that. In January, I was having coffee with Brother Avery, and I said, "Hey, Avery, can I get some? Do you know anybody where I can get some more opportunities to preach on Sundays?" And 5 seconds later, he's handing me the phone, his cell phone, and I'm on the phone with a church in Palo Alto on Middlefield Road, and 2 weeks later, I'm preaching at that church. And during that process, hanging out at that church, I realized that, you know, they were doing this pulpit supply thing for a couple years without a pastor. And I said, hey, you know, how about if, you know, we maybe put together a plan, I can help you folks out. And they said, great idea. So we started doing that. At the same time, the church was approached by another church in Palo Alto that needed space. So they've submitted a proposal. So there was a proposal for Dan to help, and then another proposal for a church to actually move into that space. And I was excited that that God was presenting a couple different opportunities for this church, and the church voted to have this church move into their space. And I was praising God for that. At the same time, a guy named Rob Schultz, who you might know, he introduced me to another church 0.2 miles away from the church on Middlefield Road. If you ever hang out in Middlefield Road in Palo Alto, it's like it's a mini Bible Belt, right? So now I'm 0.2 miles down the road preaching at this other church who were also pushing a reset button. And it's interesting because they're a church that's been around for 100 years, and they basically want to reset how they're doing things. So they're hiring pastors, and this week they extended an offer to me.
Wow. Amen.
Yeah. Yeah, exciting stuff.
So we commissioned his pastor, and God right away said, well, thank you, because I could use him. So why don't you tell us a little bit about your duties there, and then maybe how your family fits into that move and
yeah.
whole situation.
So first of all, we're not leaving Trinity, right? It's just God using the McClure family, both here in Sunnyvale and then 13 miles away or 13 minutes away by car. And at this particular church, I think specifically because they are looking to do things a new way, they like my background because of the entrepreneurial side in me. And so I think what they're doing with me is saying, all right, Dan, come on in and help us strategically think through how to make disciples make disciples. And I'm like, oh, that's interesting, because this dude that I'm standing next to has taught me how to do that very well, right? And the two-year internship that I've been doing here at Trinity Church, it's been fascinating the way that this church has equipped me for the next move. It was even interesting during the interview, as I was sitting with the board of directors and elders, and they were asking me questions like, hey, Dan, you know, what's your take on pastoral care? And during the internship, we spent a couple months unpacking what it means around pastoral care. And I'm like, oh, it's funny you ask. I have a document on that. And then they asked me this question like, well, Dan, what is your faith? What is your faith statement? I'm like, well, that's interesting, because we spent a couple months on that question, you know, unpacking what it means to have faith and what that specifically means to me. I'm like, oh, by the way, here. So what's nice is that I'm so grateful for this church and the way that this church is modeling kingdom advancement and growth. It's not about packing more people in. It's about making disciples, right? So that's what I'm charged to do at this church. The denomination is Disciples of Christ. So let's go make disciples.
Amen. And we're going to see you, especially your family.
Yeah.
Still.
We're still going to hang out here just to get, you know, equipped and hanging out here on Wednesday nights and seeing us occasionally on Sundays. And, you know, this church, because it's a very small church, it's like 30 people. There's a lot of things that they need to install, like a solid, you know, children's program, that type of thing. So my wife and kids will be primarily hanging out here, still being filled up and hanging out with this family while the other church builds up. It's kind of like a church plant inside a church. So as that church figures out systems and programs and those kinds of things, then you'll still see us in and out, just to confuse anymore.
And then how can we pray for you and your family?
Yeah. So it's been an interesting week. You know, here this church extends an offer to us. On the same week, my wife receives an email that her position will no longer be available to her. So God is on the move. And if you hang out with my wife, she, when you look at the fruits of the fruit of the Spirit, I love my wife because she embodies those things. And rather than getting angry or upset, she's like, all right, God, this is awesome. What are you doing with us? Because it feels like you're clearing the table for what's next. However, all that being said, please pray for us during that transition. Right? Because we need to be covered with spiritual protection from our family, right? We need your love to cover and protect us so that as we move into new ministry, that the enemy, you know, can't do his silly little things that he tries to do, like kill, steal, and destroy. Amen?
Amen. All right, well, let's do that. Let's pray for the McClures now. We pray with me. Father, I thank you for Dan and all that he's been a blessing to us, dear God, how he's continually encouraged us and been a model of listening for the Holy Spirit, not just believing and doing good things, but taking time out and listening. What is the Spirit saying? And stepping out in faith and really getting joyfully excited about the good news, dear Lord. And I just thank you for the blessing that the whole family has been on us. And we pray, Lord, that same blessing that we have received, dear Lord, like you said, leave your peace, bless those. We ask the blessing upon them, that may go, ministry may go forth, that where you place them in this new body, dear Lord, that they may also experience that same stirring of the Holy Spirit, that same passion, that same revival spirit of let's see God do a new thing and a yes, new work to advance his kingdom, because it is worth giving your life to God.
Thank you.
I pray, dear Lord, specifically for patience to wait on your plan, even in the midst of this new thing, dear God, that you are up to with Annette and what you would have for her, dear God. I pray that their joy may just continue to stir. I'm sure it will be challenged. Anytime you're working in ministry in a new situation, dear God, it's exciting, and then we meet real people, and it's not so exciting. And we need you, dear God, to stir in them just the way you say, way you stir in us, dear God, to remember you are about the process, and you want them to fully experience where it is now so they can appreciate the transformation of where you're going to take it to be. Would you do that work in them? Would you do that work through them, dear God? Protect their kids, continue to connect them here, and then in bring the right kind of relationships and people into the new body, dear God, to kind of connect and grow them. I also pray that for both Dan and Annette, that you would bring along a couple, dear Father, some folks in their lives that will just pour into them on that side, dear God. Also that they can pour into. We pray, dear Lord, that you bless them. And that you unshower, dear Lord, just things that they could not imagine or think. From whether it's vocation, whether it's really kingdom, because I know this is their desire, kingdom outcome, dear God. I pray that you continue, that you leverage this, dear Father, in their neighborhoods. I know that they care and love their neighbors and want to continue to be a channel of your grace and love for them. So that it's just be a strategic even step in that, dear Father. Thank you, Lord, that though we don't have all the answers, and there's a lot of ifs, ands, and buts, dear God, we know that we have a God who can do beyond what we can imagine or think, and it's always for our good. So it's in the name of the one who's that object lesson for us, Jesus, that we pray and ask these things. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Thanks, Joel.
Thank you. Brother. All right.